yesterday's class?
Classes and objects, differentiation between
object and what is class, right?
Yeah, so
and one more important point we discussed, like to access the members of the class, we have to create object of the class.
Right.
And use the object with the dot operator only, we can access the members. So this
right.
is the
and
important point we require actually.
And a class has behavior and states of its members. Behaviors are defined by methods. States are defined by data types, data members.
Data members means variables. We can say like variables. So a class is a collection of data members and methods. To access
yeah.
the members of the class, we need to create object. With object, we access the members with the dot operator. So these are the major points required for us.
Yeah.
We'll enter into this. Yeah. We'll enter into this.
So yesterday what I was asking, I have seen usage because in my company there are multiple projects running with Java. So the major confusion area was that they were using short form of creating objects. So either via this operator or only dot members, and there are multiple notations.
We'll come to that. Yeah. So because I don't want to create a lot of confusion initially.
Mm-hmm.
One second. One more time. Hello. Hello. Are you able to hear me, Jayanti?
Hello.
Yeah, and so let me list out the features present in Java, the Java features. This even we call it as buzzwords. Buzzwords means the words what we use in Java related words. The common words which we keep on using, that is the name called as buzzwords.
Okay.
Regular usage words are called as buzzwords. We are in totally 10 important features of Java. They are, Java is simple. Java is object oriented. Java is robust. Platform independent. Interpreted. Portable, secure, multi-threaded, dynamic, and distributed. So these are the 10 important features of Java. And today our objective is to discuss a small overview of all these features. And once we enter into Java programming, we'll be discussing every feature in detail.
Okay.
So let us start off with the first one. Java is simple. Java is what? Simple. So why we say Java is simple? Because when you take other programming languages like C and C++, so we are having a concept like arrays. So do you have idea of arrays, Anuj?
Yeah.
Jayanti, do you have idea of arrays? Some background. Jayanti, can unmute and speak. Click on the same symbol, mic symbol, to unmute. Yes, Jayanti, do you have idea of arrays?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what is array? It's a collection of elements. However, we discuss in Java again. So it's a collection of elements. Now what we want to do, we want to sort the elements of the array. Sorting means what? Arranging in ascending order or descending order. So in the case of C and C++, in order to sort the elements, we need to write some 10 to 15 lines of code, right?
Mm-hmm.
Both of you. But in case of Java, we complete the task only with one line. Just we use a predefined class in Java. We use a predefined class in Java called as arrays with a method sort, and we pass the array name. That's it. we pass the array name where n is the array. So this one line of code will sort the elements of your array. Means one line of code is doing your task. In that way, we say Java is simple. Why we say Java is simple? Because it contains lots of methods where we can complete the task very easily. So Java is simple as it contains lots of APIs. Lots of APIs. The meaning of API is application programming interfaces. Or we say library. Okay, or we call it as library, a predefined methods, predefined classes, which goes with some predefined methods. They are called as APIs in Java. The libraries are called as what? APIs. Okay. And in future, I'll show you how to open API and how to browse API and how to complete the task using APIs. Okay. All these things I'll show you practically. Okay. Thanks.
Okay.
Hello. Hello, Sandeep. Are you able to hear me? Yeah. Just I started Java features with simple. So we say Java is simple because it contains lots of APIs. API means application programming interfaces, which even we call it as libraries. Clear, Anuj, Jayanti?
Yeah, clear.
Right? Yeah, we'll be keep on discussing on this terminology API. Clear, Jayanti?
Yes, sir.
Object oriented. Object. We say Java is object oriented. Yesterday only I said Java supports all the object oriented features. So Java is object oriented as it supports all the OO features. Like what are the features? Objects, classes, abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism. And polymorphism. So we'll be discussing all these terminologies using Java technology, using Java programming, and this concept will go for 5 days pass. Okay. Until that time, don't worry about this abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism. Java is robust, very good feature. Java is robust. Why we say Java is robust? Robust means what? Any idea? Synonym of robust? Yes, NH?
Non-destructible or?
Yeah, something like that. So strong. Robust means strong. Okay, let me take an example to you. Let us suppose you are typing a document in Microsoft Word or any document related where you can able to document like Notepad or any editors. So once you type the document, we want to print the document. After typing the document, we want to print it. When you issue the print command, but the printer is not connected to your system, then what is going to happen? When you have given print option, printer is not connected to your system, then what is going to happen? Will your application will give a message to you that printer not connected, or will it close the application? Message or close?
Message.
We get only the message, right? We get the message that printer not connected. Means your application, that is Microsoft Word, is strong, robust. Which indicate what it means? Robust means, so whenever we are running an application, if any abnormal situation occurs, like printer not connected, the application should give proper message to the user what went wrong. Should not close the application automatically. So such type of things only we say robust applications. Clear the meaning of robust?
No, basically okay. what message it will give. It depends upon exception handling, right? You cannot
right,
get
right,
message.
Right. It won't do automatically. We have to do that. That is that that feature is given in Java.
Okay.
We can able to do that. So that's the thing we are going to do, right? So we, in Java, we can develop robust applications using which concept? Exception handling. So because of this exception handling in Java, we can go with what? Robust applications, which avoids the abnormal termination of program. Which avoids what? Abnormal termination of program. So if anything happens during runtime, so when the application is running, if any abnormal situation occurs, the program should not get terminated automatically. So if any abnormal situation occurs, the application should be able to handle that runtime exception. Exception means an error, and should give proper message to the user what went wrong. And this topic we'll be discussing for 2 days. This topic goes for 2 days. Clear, Anuj?
Yep.
Jayanti?
Yes, sir.
Sandeep?
Yeah.
Then the next and very important for today is platform independent. Platform means your operating system. A Java program can run on any type of platform, any operating system. Okay, let's understand more of this platform independent with a diagram. So this feature is required for tomorrow's class. Platform independent. So the meaning of this platform independent is a Java program can run on any platform. Can run on any platform means any operating system. We can even say like a Java program is write once, run anywhere. Is a ORA. What is a Java program? Write once, run anywhere. You can run on any machine. You can write the program on one machine and you can take it and run it on any other machine. Okay. What makes a Java program is a Java program is a collection of classes. What is a Java program? It is a collection of classes. Means as an example, if you are taking a Java program like x.java, understand carefully, x.java, Java is the extension given to Java programs, and whatever the program we are going to write, we call it as source code. We call it as source code. So we give some file name, some x or y or z, whatever it may be, .java, we give extension, and this file we call it as source code. Then what is a Java program? It's a collection of classes. So we go with some classes inside the Java program like this. How to create a class? We discussed it today. We use a keyword class and some class name. So in this extra Java, how many classes we have created? Anyone?
Three
classes, right? We have created 3 classes. Remember. Then once you create the source code, the next step what we need to do is we need to compile the source code. So why we have to compile the program is, why we have to compile the source code is to check for any errors present in your program, like syntax errors. Should follow the rules of program. So to check that one, and mainly to convert into an intermediate format where your operating system can understand. So for that we have to compile your program. So to compile, the command is, to compile, we use a command at the command prompt. We are having a concept like command prompt, which I show you everywhere practically tomorrow. So at the command prompt, we take a command Java C. Java C is a predefined command in Java, which comes with the Java software, JDK, which I'll show you tomorrow, all these words. So Java C, and what's the name of the file? X.java. So in this X.java, how many classes are there?
Three
classes. So what is going to happen when you say Java creates a dot class, b dot class, and c dot class? So how many dot class files will be created here? In our example, three dot class files will be created. Depends on number of classes present in your source code, that many dot class files will be created for us. And these dot class files are called as bytecodes. What is the terminology we use? The dot class files are called as what? Bytecodes. And these bytecodes are platform independent. So what makes Java platform independent means we say bytecodes. So if you type this Java program on Windows and if you compile, it will generate the dot class files, and I can use these dot class files on any operating system without modifying any single line of code. Got it? Clear up here, Anuj?
Can you repeat this one?
Yeah, which one?
When we have compiled the program.
Yeah, when we compile the program, depends on number of classes present in source code. In our example, three classes are there. So that many dot class files will be created for us.
So even if one class file has one Java file has three classes, there will be three class files created?
Yes.
Okay, and they will be in bytecode. We cannot read
that,
it.
Yeah, that is called as bytecode, means an intermediate format where your operating system can understand.
Okay.
So if you open this dot class, we won't understand. It will be in machine format, okay?
And this bytecode, whichever operating system we will take it onto, that already understands how to
right. Interpret it. Understand. This bytecode can be understood by any operating system. Okay. Yeah. Clear.
Okay.
JNT. Hello, Jayanti? Yeah, are you able to hear me now? Yeah, so clear with this concept, any questions? Right? Yeah. Once we compile the program, the next step is we need to run the program. We have to run the application. So, to run
Raj.
Java program, yes, Andy.
Can we demonstrate this one? Basically, I understand there will be three classes created, but I have never seen.
I'll be discussing all these the theoretical words tomorrow programmatically.
Okay. So use a bytecode from, say, a command prompt in some other language and still some other platform and still see that it is working.
Yeah, it will be same command. Any platform, commands are same.
Okay.
So there won't be any change. Either Windows or Mac or anything, the commands remain same. It won't change. Okay, Sandeep?
Yeah.
Okay.
But can we see it? We can see tomorrow.
Yes, Sandeep. Yeah. Okay. We because today our discussion is, you missed it, right? So today our discussion is, we'll be discussing these 10 important features of Java. That is the objective for today. Overview of Java, you can see.
Okay.
And tomorrow I'll be entering into this. What are the concepts I'm saying? I'll show you practically everything. How to compile, how to download Java, how to compile, how to run, everything I'll show you. Okay, Sandeep?
Yeah.
To run a Java program, at least one class should contain main method. To run a Java program, at least one class should contain the main method. Why main method? Main method is the entry point to run a Java program. Why main method? It is an entry point to run a Java program. So you can go with a class with the main method. A class with main method, some code inside this. We are not worried about code today. So we can go with B class also main method. So Java supports multiple main methods. We can go with multiple main methods in our classes. Okay, yes. How to run? And before that, one more important point I want to give. We can run only dot class files. We can run only dot class files which contains main method. Which contains main method. This point is very, very important. Let me elaborate. To run, the command is Java. Java C is for compiling and Java is for running. Java, and if you say A or if you say Java B, you can even, if you say Java C, what is going to happen? Let us see. Java X. Let us come from last. So when you say Java X, what is going to happen? What is this X here? It's the name of the source code, X.java. So what is going to happen? Very good. There is no dot class file for X. Okay. It's X.java is only the name of the source code. It's only the name of the source code. What is the point I have given? We can run only dot class files. So it will go with what you get? Error. It will show an error, that is no class definition form. It will give what message to us? No class definition form. Then if you say Java C, what is going to happen?
There is no main in it, so it is not
no main method. Classy based on our example, so it is again says error, no main method found. Means what? No main method found. Then if you say Java B, runs the program from B class main method. Runs the program from B class main method. The entry point is B class main method. And if you say Java A, runs the program from A class main method. Runs the program from where? A class main method. So whichever the main method you want to run, that class we have to pass to the Java command. Clear, Anuj?
Yeah.
Sandeep?
Yes.
Jayanti?
Yes, sir.
Any questions up to here, anyone?
No, we can continue.
Yeah, I'll discuss every minute part of this, whatever I discussed, programmatically tomorrow. Okay.
Just one thing. What will be the case when we require different main methods and different classes? Yeah. Ideally, there should be only one main method.
You want to, because of in, so you have written A class, C class, and from B, the entry point I'm saying B. If I run Java B, I want to make use of features of A and C, right? That is your question.
Mm-hmm. No, no.
Then just to create the object.
I'm asking, ideally there should be only one main method and it should be connecting all classes, right?
Right. Otherwise, right. That's the best way we write actually. But Java did not say that. Java programming did not give that rule. Java says you can go with multiple main methods.
Okay.
But as a good programming practice, we go with only one main method. Mm-hmm. As a programmer, we go with one main method, but Java did not mention that we should go only with one main method. That rule is not given by Java. So still it supports. That's the point I'm discussing. Okay, Anuj?
Okay. Right? And one, maybe it's a question that we can deal later on. If some other application has to call our application, can it call only via the class having main method, or it can also call a different class?
Anything. Any class it can call. Any class, we have to create object of it and call it, use it. That's it.
Okay, so that won't require any main method over
here. Not required.
Okay.
We go with thousands of classes. One class should go with one main method. That's it. Why main? Only to run the program.
No,
only two
but
lines. Java and
if
second is
other
it.
party is calling, it can call any class that is without main method also. Okay. Okay.
So to Java command, I can pass only the class which contains main method. That is the point is required.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So when this
okay.
is main method is only for standalone applications. Standalone means only
right. independently running.
Yeah, independent. So when you go for web applications, again main method is not required. We go with a different approach, advanced Java. Okay.
Okay.
Let us go with the next feature, interpreted. So in this one, Java C command is a compiler and Java command is an interpreter. Java C is a compiler and Java is interpreter. So anyone is having idea what is the difference between compiler and interpreter?
Compiler used to interpreter used to go line by line and compiler
Very
used
good.
To only check syntax of the program.
We use the word at a time. So
compiler
Sorry? Means at a time.
At
so
a
it will
time.
Keep the complete
yeah.
source code and it will convert complete source code into bytecode at a time. Whereas
okay.
interpreter line by line. It will execute line by line.
Right. So
right.
do we have interpreter in Java?
Yes, both the things. Java is both compiler as well as interpreter. So Java C is a compiler and Java command goes with interpreter. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So while running the program, it is going line by line.
Line by line. When it is converting into bytecode, at a time. So Java command is an interpreter. Java command is interpreter. So what is this interpreter? Java interpreter executes the bytecode line by line. So whenever I say interpreter, always remember any programming language line by line. Executes the bytecode line by line, and if any line contains error, the program will be terminated. The program will be terminated. So to avoid this abnormal termination only, we go with exception. When I come to exception handling, I'll discuss more of how Java interpreter is working once. Okay, all of you?
Okay.
Sandeep, any questions? So let me even select. Java C is a compiler. What is compiler? Java compiler converts source code into bytecode at a time. So whenever we say interpreter, any programming language line by line, compiler means okay. So tomorrow I'll show you this concept called as what is this at a time practically. Portable. Java is portable. So why we say Java is portable here? Because when you take C and C++, what is size of integer data type? Any idea? What is size of integer data type in the case of C and C++?
2 bytes.
2 bytes. It is 2 bytes. So 2 bytes on 32-bit operating system.
Yeah.
It is 2 bytes on 32-bit operating system
four
and
bytes.
4 bytes on 64-bit operating system. So the size is differing. The size is differing when you take C and C++ data types. In the case of C and C++, so when you take integer data type, it is 2 bytes on 32 and 4 bytes on 64. If you write a C language program on 32-bit, and if you take the same program to 64-bit, then do I need to take care of memory issues? That means I need to go to the program and check whether there are any memory issues in the program. Right? You have to take care of memory issues in the program. That's the reason this is C and C++ are not highly portable. They are not highly portable. Shifting of source code from one platform to other platform, you may require to do some changes in the source code. You may require some changes in source code. But in Java, you need not do any changes in the source code, even if you change the platform also. Why? Because in Java, the size of all data types is same, no change. Java is portable. Since in Java, the size of all data types. So once we enter into Java basics, that is from Monday, I'll discuss what are the data types present in Java and what are the sizes on Monday when I enter into Java basics. So Java is portable since in Java, the size of all data types is same on all platforms. Is same on all platforms. Clear? Anuj, Jayanti and Sandeep?
Yep.
Right? Clear, Jayanti?
Yes.
Right? I'll discuss data type exactly. Enter into Java basics.
But exactly, it must be allocating 2-byte, 4-byte on based on like float is always higher.
So in the case of Java, integer is 4 bytes. Long means 8 bytes. Double also 8 bytes, like that. But it is same for all operations. That is the point.
So can I run a program that was compiled on a 64-bit operating system on a 32-bit? Because yes, it will anyway allocate more memory.
In case of Java, the size is common for all operating systems.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the point. Because of that only we say Java is portable. We need not go to source code and take care of memory issues. That's the point. Okay. Then, Java is secure. So why we say Java is secure here? Because You can mute yourself. Yeah, thank you. So we say Java is secure. Why? Because Java does not support a concept called as pointers. Let us understand what is a pointer. A pointer is a variable which contains address of some other variable. Let me go with the example, like this is only related to C++. When you declare the variable, and if you want to take the address of the variable, we use and n. And n will give address of n, and then we'll give address of n. This address, we want to store it into some other variable. And we declare like a pointer, like star symbol we use. So since p is containing the address of n, then we call this p as a pointer. A pointer is a variable which contains address of some other variable. What is the use of pointer is, when pointer contains address of some other variable, by using pointer, I can go to this any variable and modify the value. So from now onwards, you need not use any variable. I can use pointer only to go to the n variable address and modify the value of it. Means using pointer, we can go to some other memory space and change it or corrupt it also. We can even corrupt it. That's the reason. Using pointers only, we develop virus or antivirus applications. Virus and antivirus applications are done with what? Pointer concept. That means pointers are not secure. That's the reason Java people remove this concept called as pointers in Java. There are no pointer concepts in Java. So even though there is no background of pointers for you, don't worry, because there are no pointer concept in Java. So what is the point? Java is secure as Java does not support pointers, as pointers violate security. As pointers violate security. Clear this point, all of you?
Yeah.
Right? Multi-threaded, one more very good feature of Java, multi-threaded. What is multitasking?
Running two things in parallel.
Yeah, can you go with examples?
Driving a car and listening to song.
Right, yeah, in our software related.
An operating system is having multiple applications which are running in parallel. So you can open Microsoft Word, do some processing in parallel. The songs are working
right
on
yeah
the same operating
that
system.
multitasking. So in my case, what I've done, I've opened a browser, Skype is running, Notepad is there, Webinar is there, Paint is there. So different applications we are open here. So every application is a task here. Then what is a thread? What is a thread? Have you seen threads anytime?
Thread is each application only?
Yeah, thread is inside the application. So let me take example. If you take our webinar, if you take our this webinar only, what are the different activities we are doing in this webinar? I can show my screen, right?
Yeah, mute, unmute is a different
mute and
thread.
It's a thread.
Participant
I can record the class. It's a thread.
Yeah.
I can chat with you. It's a thread. Okay. So these are threads. Mm-hmm. Let me take one more good example. If you take our Gmail only, if you take our Gmail, how many compose windows we can open? So Gmail is a task and application.
N number of.
Gmail,
yeah.
How many compose? N number of compose messages. So every compose message is a thread here. It's a
okay.
It's a thread. So when you go for attachments, how many attachments we can do?
Any number of attachments.
Any number, right? So when the attachments are going on, can I still attach some more?
Yeah.
Yes, because every attachment is a thread over here. Every attachment is a thread. And when attachments are going on, can I type the subject and body of the message?
Yeah.
Yes, because compose is a different thread, attachments are different threads here. And what is the advantage we get because of this multi-thread?
While we can save our time.
Right, that's a major advantage. Like we can save the time. So we can increase the performance of application. So Gmail has become popular only because of this multi-threading. Got it? So when you take like Rediff, if I open one compose message, one if I write one mail, when I attach one file, until that attachment is over, I activate. Waste of time, lot of waste of time will be there. But whereas Gmail, it goes with multi-threading. Clear, all of you, the advantage of multi-threading?
Yeah, and what happens in case of Java?
Yeah, we can develop this type of applications in Java. Multi-threaded applications, that's the meaning we are saying. So we can increase performance of Java applications using multi-threading. We can distribute the work. That's it. So we can
and
select.
We were able to do that from traditional languages also?
C++ we can do, but C language no.
Okay.
C language we cannot go with multi-threading.
Okay.
So a thread is a lightweight process.
And even in Python and these languages?
Yes, Python also supports multi-threading.
Okay.
So a thread is a lightweight process under execution within a process. Within a process. So if you take process like Gmail, the lightweight process are like compose message, chat windows, attachments. All these are your threads. And the advantage of going for multi-threading is multi-threading is used to increase the performance of application. So whenever you want to increase performance of application, we have to apply multi-threading concept in there. And this topic will go for 2 days for us. How to develop multi-threaded applications in Java, and with that, how to increase performance of application. And this topic will go for 2 days for us. Okay, Anuj?
Okay.
Yeah, Jayanti and Sandeep?
Yeah.
Right. dynamic. Java is what? Dynamic. So when you take your C and C++, memory allocation for arrays or objects will happen during compile time only. But in case of Java, memory allocation happens during runtime. That's the reason we say dynamic. So Java is dynamic. Since in Java, memory allocation is done during runtime. The meaning of runtime is dynamic. So even we say Java, one more feature, Java is automatic garbage collection. Java is automatic garbage collection means in the case of C and C++, if you allocate memory, disallocation of memory also should be taken care by programmer only. Disallocation need to be taken care by programmer. But in Java, as a programmer, our work is only to allocate memory. As a Java programmer, our work is only to allocate memory. Disallocation of memory is taken care by Java only. So that feature only we say automatic garbage collection. We'll discuss more on this point once again in future with good examples.
Okay.
Right. One more very good feature of Java is distributed. Let us understand what is this distributed with a diagram. So let us understand the feature distributed. So the meaning of distributed is like, for example, we want to recharge a mobile. We want to recharge our mobile. So what are the different ways we are having to recharge the mobile now? Paytm, right? We can use Paytm to recharge. Okay. And we can go with this like free recharge.com. We can say online recharge.com, or you can use net banking to recharge. We want to recharge the Airtel mobile. We want to recharge the Airtel mobile. So whenever you want to recharge the Airtel mobile, we want to browse the plans available in Airtel. You want to recharge what? Airtel mobile. So what we want to do? We want to browse the plans available. So where the plans will be available? Will it available in this way, in this websites, or will it be available in Airtel server? The latest
Airtel server.
Airtel server only, right? Because Airtel, the people of Airtel will be keep on updating the plans. So they'll update only in Airtel. So the plans are available with in this server only. So we'll be having a module called as get plans. Let us assume. And this get plans will connect to a database. In database, they will modify the plans. So it will be having its own database. And this get plans module will connect to this database to get the plans available. Now these clients, let me say these are the clients here. These clients want to know the plans available. They want to browse the plans available. Then the solution is, if I give this complete code to the clients, we are having two drawbacks. If you give this complete code to the clients, we are having two drawbacks. One is, in future, if I modify the plans, do I need to give that updated code every time to clients?
They don't need to. They should not be updating. They only need to get the plans.
Right. That's only if I give the complete code to the clients. I'm taking this example. Whatever the code present in server, if that code need to be executed by clients, if I give this code to the clients, the problem is what? The drawback is, in future, if I modify this code in server, do I need to give that updated code every time to the clients? That's the question.
Yeah.
Yes, we have to give. That is one drawback. And one more drawback is database. So sharing of database is very difficult over network, right? Bigger size, mm-hmm. and for security reasons, we won't share database also, right?
Yeah.
So these are the drawbacks when you share the code. Then the solution is, we have to make this application as distributed. We have to make this application as what? Distributed. The meaning of distributed is, when the client connects to this application from outside, the execution happens on the server only. The execution happens on the server and the results will come to you. And what are the results you are getting? I can take that output and use it for other programming. I can use it for other programming means distributed application is mainly for exchanging data from one application to other application, application to application. You may get confused with this one, like websites. So if you take this Amazon, if you go with Amazon, so it is displaying the list of products to you, right? So if I say something like mobile phones, so it will show the mobile phones. So whatever the mobile phones it is displaying for you, can I take this code and use it for some other purpose? Can I take this output and develop some other application here?
No, right?
It's only website. It is called as website. Yeah. Whereas distributed means application to application interaction. Distributed means application to application interaction. So this distributed concept is nowhere related to end users. Nowhere related to end users. Got it? The meaning of distributed? Some basic idea? Right? So don't worry too much today. So we'll be discussing. So what is the need of distributed? Distributed applications are used for the purpose of exchanging data from one application to another application. Let me take one more good example for you to understand about distributed. Let us suppose, yes.
In that way, is every language a distributed language? Because exchange of data happens almost everywhere, right?
No, they should have a connection. Yes, almost all the languages support the distributed, like PHP, C++, Java, .NET, Python, all supports distributed.
Okay.
Let me take one more good example for you. Let us suppose you are having a Citibank ATM with you. Citibank ATM card. So can I use that Citibank ATM card in HDFC Bank?
Yeah.
Yes. So when you take your Citibank ATM to HDFC Bank ATM, then what is going to happen? Will it connect to Citibank server immediately when you keep the card?
Yes, it should, because if it does not, it will not know my balance.
It will connect to Citibank server. Then once it connects to Citibank server, will it give all the customer details of Citibank server to HDFC Bank now?
No, the necessary one.
Right, sir. Security reasons, we won't give. So the processing will happen at Citibank server only. It will authenticate whether you are authenticated or not at Citibank server only. And it will give the result back to you, that is, the card is authenticated. So they are exchanging the data. So whatever the card you kept in HDFC Bank ATM, it will read your card details and sends the details to Citibank server. The processing will happen at Citibank server and it will give the authentication details back to HDFC Bank. And once the card is authenticated, you want to withdraw the money. So when you want to withdraw the money, again the details will go to Citibank server. The processing will happen at Citibank server and the results will come back to you. So they are exchanging data from one application to other application. Are they interacting?
Yeah.
That interaction only we say distributed.
Okay.
Got it now?
Yes.
Right? Here, Anuj, the meaning of distributed. So it is application to application only. Okay? Yeah. Anything? Right?
Yes.
So these are the features what we discussed today. So what are the features? Java is simple, object oriented, robust, platform independent, interpreted, portable, secure, multi-threaded, dynamic and distributed. So we'll see every feature in detail once again, and for entering into tomorrow's class, just to recap this feature once again. So in tomorrow we are going to discuss about how to download Java, install Java on our machines, and how to develop a Java application tomorrow, and how to compile and run it. Complete practical approach, we start from tomorrow onwards. Okay, all of you?
Okay. Right?
Yeah. Any questions?
No.
Jay, anything?
Sir, how will you handle the programming session through online?
Absolutely. Tomorrow I'll be showing you. Tomorrow we start writing the programs. Okay, I'll show you how to download Java, everything, practical approach. Okay, Jayanti?
Okay. Sir, if you need
tomorrow you'll understand. Yeah. Yes, Jayanti?
During
yeah,
the session, yeah? Rectifiers, through online, how can you...
I did not get you, Jayanti. Can you repeat?
Sir, how was the practical sessions going through online?
If yeah, that only I'll be showing to you tomorrow. How to do it programs, I'll show you tomorrow.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, I'll show you complete practical approach, how to download, how to install Java, and how to write Java programs, I'll show you tomorrow, which you need to practice. And from the next week, I'll be start giving assignments to you. I'll be showing the programs, lot of examples, and I'll be giving assignments to you, which you need to develop on your machine and submit back to us. Okay? And any issues if you are getting to write Java programs, I'll help you out. Okay? I'll connect to your machine. Okay. You can show your screen to me, and I'll check what errors you are doing. Okay? Don't worry. I'll take every minute.
Okay.
Okay? Right? So that's about for today. Thank you all. See you tomorrow. Thank you all.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.